What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to record your screen on your macOS using OBS Studio. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. First of all, you should make sure that OBS is installed on your system and that you're running the latest software update. Open up your favorite browser and navigate to obsproject.com. From here, select to download the Mac installer for the Intel or Apple Silicon version. This basically means that if you're running the M1 or M2 Mac, then download the Apple Silicon installer. And if you're using an Intel processor, then download the Intel installer. In case you're unsure, then click on the Apple icon in your taskbar and select About this Mac. Under Overview, you can preview which processor you are using. After downloading the corresponding installer, which should only take a minute or two to complete, you can navigate to your downloads folder and close your browser. Double-click the DMG file, which will open up a new Finder window, where you should drag and drop the OBS icon into your applications folder. After installing OBS to your system, proceed to open up the application. On the bottom left of your screen, you can preview your scenes and sources. Click on the plus icon in the Scenes panel to add a new scene. You can name this whatever you want. Next, click on the plus icon in the Sources panel and make sure to select Display Capture in this list of sources. Select to create a new source and name this to your liking. On the next window, you can then proceed to select the correct display to be captured, and if you wish to crop your recorded window. After clicking on OK, you should see your screen in the OBS preview. Click and drag the handles of your display capture preview to resize the recorded screen. If you prefer to record a specific window and not your entire screen, then you should make use of the window capture source. It will allow you to choose a specific window when first setting up this source. You can also record your default sound output or input, such as your voice, using a microphone. In your audio mixer, change the recorded sound volume with this slider for your desktop audio or your microphone. You can change the device when clicking on the gear icon for the device and selecting properties. After this initial setup, you should take a look at your OBS settings to make sure that your screen recordings look the best without causing lag or low performance on your device. Under Controls, click on Settings. Here, navigate to the Output tab and make sure to set the Output Mode option to Advanced. This will give you access to some additional settings. In the Recording section of your Output settings, set the type to Standard. And below, you can change the recording path if you want. I like to select my desktop, and it will be in your videos or movies folder by default. Set the recording format to MP4. This is the best video format for most users, as it won't require much storage space for the quality, and it will allow you to edit the video using most applications and upload it to most websites. The encoder option should be set to X264, as this will result in the best OBS performance for Mac users. If you have access to a dedicated graphics card, then it will show up in this list. It will then be favorable to use it, but for most users, make sure to set this to X264. Below, you have the option to rescale your video output. If you're using an abnormal native screen resolution, as I am, then make sure not to change your output resolution here, as we will be able to change it later on. Next, set the rate control to CBR, which stands for constant bitrate. Below, make sure to use a decent bitrate to get enough detail in your video. In case you're recording your screen in 1080p, then a bitrate of 10,000 should be enough. This will also depend on which type of content you are recording. Video games, for example, require a higher bitrate, as there is more overall movement on your screen. In my example, I am recording in 2K resolution and 60 FPS, a bitrate of 20,000, which will require about 20 megabytes per recorded second, is more than enough to record my screen in this setting. When recording in 720p, a bitrate of 3 or 4,000 can suffice, depending on which content you're intending to record. I suggest trying out a few values around 10,000 to see what works best for you. A higher bitrate will, in any case, use up more of your available storage, so keep that in mind. Below, set the keyframe interval to 2 seconds. Your CPU usage preset should be set to how new and fast your processor is running. Higher-end CPUs should use medium or fast, and older processors should work best with the very fast or super fast preset. Lastly, set your profile to main and tune to none. After taking a look at your output settings, we will take a quick look at your video settings. Here, make sure that your base or canvas resolution is set to your native screen resolution. Below, you have the option to rescale your video output to a lower resolution using the same aspect ratio. To get the best video quality, make sure to set the downscale filter to Lanczos when recording your screen. Lastly, choose a frame rate. For gaming, you might want to set this to 60 FPS, and when recording simple applications, then 30 FPS should be enough as you're not recording as much movement. You can then start recording your screen by clicking on Start Recording, or use the shortcuts to start and stop the screen recording. In case your Mac is getting slow, or if you experience lag while recording, then make sure that you're running the latest software update. In your System Preferences, navigate to Software Update and make sure to download and install the latest macOS version to your system. This will also require you to restart your Mac, which will prevent some applications from running in the background, using up your Mac resources. More tips on how to improve your screen recordings with OBS on your Mac can be found in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.